Hey, fifth graders, this is your social studies vocabulary for lesson six, the bus and boat tour of the Southeast. You need to write down the meanings, the definitions, and record visuals. The visuals I have are inspirational ones. If you prefer a different one, then do that as you please. You should have in class done these three words, swamp, savanna, and hurricane already. You may not have gotten the pictures for them, but you should have those ones down first. If at any time you need to pause this video, do that so that you can easily write down the words. So the next words that you need include minerals, a natural material found in a rock, and my picture shows three different minerals that when combined create a certain rock. You might think about what you did in science class, right, in one of your last readers. Then we have strip mine, a place where minerals are scraped from the ground. This shows a picture so you can see how they dug in these different layers in order to find the minerals that they wanted to mine. Then we have delta. A delta is a triangular-shaped area of land at the end of a river. I liked this picture because I thought it really showed you the river and how when a river flows, it carries sediment, which I think is a word you know from science. Yeah. It deposits the sediment at the end of the river, making these kind of, almost looks like a tree. And you can see like the triangle shape too. Then we have bayou. Bayou is a stream that flows through a swamp. So that would be water all the time. Petroleum, a thick black liquid found underground. You might know this word. You might know the word petroleum jelly, which is what Vaseline is. You might know that in England they call gas petrol. And that petrol is also where we get our gasoline for our cars comes originally from oil. Okay, so you can think of how those words are connected. Then we have plantation, a large farm usually worked by many laborers. I found a picture of a giant farm just to show you. It's not a small farm, it's a huge giant farm. So you might draw lots and lots and lots of fields of different kinds of crops. So then lastly, and I hope we all know at this point that you should have flipped the paper over, and that no one is going to say, I didn't know there was a back to the paper. Okay, there are three or four definitions on the back of the paper. So the last word actually is segregation. It's actually a good one probably to be doing since Monday's Martin Luther King Day. Right, Liam?
Yeah.
Liam Benson's a special guest star here today as I'm recording this video. And so here's the word, segregation. So you may have heard just Ginevra too, so she just piped in too, trying to get this recorded in time for the end of the day. So anyway, segregation unfortunately was an issue mostly in the southern part of our country after the Civil War up through the 1960s, where the separation of people because of race, in this case race, religion, or gender. So when we try to segregate people, we try to put them in a certain spot or a certain place, and we try to do that because we think they're different. So I took this picture, which is from the 1960s or 1950s, which says drinking fountain, and they had them separated, which I think you've probably heard these stories before when you were in the younger grades, when you've learned about Martin Luther King or maybe Rosa Parks or Ruby Bridges, that things were separate. Okay, so you think of how you want to draw a picture for that. Now, remember, I talked fast for in this video, so at any time, pause the video, write down what you need to write down, draw down your pictures, and for room 8 and 18, this is due next Thursday, January 19th. And if you're in room 7 or 10, this is due next Friday, January 20th. This is Mrs. P signing off.